में जिंदगी का आगाज कैसे हुआ, हाउ लाइफ एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड। दे स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग फ्रॉम द टाइम व्हेन एक्चुअली वाटर अराइव्ड इन अपॉन आवर प्लैनेट। पानी कहाँ से आया? सो दे एक्चुअली लिंक दैट थिंग विद द वाटर एंड देन आफ्टर दैट इट एक्चुअली प्रोसीड विद द फॉलोइंग थिंग्स एंड द फॉलोइंग इवेंट्स, चेन ऑफ इवेंट्स। एंड दिस यू कैन सी द पिक्चर, दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एन इंसेक्ट। इट्स अ स्पाइडर used to hunt and go down and dive down deep into the water, and they cannot take they cannot get air from the water. So the spider created a bubble around itself and preserve that and take that bubble with itself to try a dive to catch a prey beneath the surface of the water. So ये scuba diving करते, something like that. So air is important, but for some organisms you might heard that there are many organisms which who knows that how to live in the absence of oxygen, because there are many places where oxygen is not present, like deep beneath the surface on the floor of the ocean, deep beneath the surface. There was no oxygen dissolved in water there. So the organisms which are present on the floor of the ocean, most of them, they are not dependent on oxygen. They can live without oxygen. So they find alternative ways. We will see what those ways are. Okay, let's proceed with the next important thing, that is habitat. Habitat is the kind of a place to live. It's not like our home, which we believe. It's not like this one, a place to live. Habitat is a certain things are required by an organism to survive. But some organisms or some animals require a very large space to live. Some organism and animals can survive even at a very smaller places. Salman asked me ki wo jo animals or organisms hote hain jo oxygen ke bagair rehte hain, kya unko respire karna padta hai? They do need energy. Ye zaruri hai, unko energy chahiye. But they find another way of respiration where oxygen is not required. They found an alternative way of producing energy where oxygen is not required. Okay, but energy unko chahiye hoti hai. So habitat is a set of things which must be provided to an organism to exist in a normal way. Some people or some animals required a very large habitat. Some can live on a very small area of land, like. You can see certain animals only exist in water. You can see certain types of animals and plants only exist in mountains. You can see certain types of animals and plants only exist on the plains. So the mountains is a different habitat. The temperature, humidity, climate, all these things are different on mountains. Desert is a different type of ecosystem. It's a different habitat. Desert can support a different form of life. For example, just let me give you a quick example. The plants present in the desert, either they have a very deep roots so that they can get water present beneath the surface, because the water is not present near the surface, or they have a very spreaded roots just beneath the surface. So jab barish hoti hai, they can get the water immediately, quickly, as much as possible, and then they preserve it. And if the plants present in the desert, they know how to preserve water. वो water को preserve रखते हैं. उनकी skin, उनका structure ऐसा होता है, they can preserve water. But the plants present in the mountains, which are having abundance of water, lot of water over there, they don't need to preserve it. They don't need to create very deep roots in order to get the water, because they can the supply of water is already abundant. So different types of habitat support different versions of life. If one animal move from one habitat to another, it will not be possible for that animal to live over there. For example, polar bear ki zindagi kitni mushkil hai. A polar bear life is very, very difficult. The polar bear is living like minus 50, minus 60. It seems very, you know, unkind for all of us to imagine a life out there. But for the polar bear, it's a normal life. If the polar bear comes to Lahore, he or she will die, because the habitat is not supporting the structure of that animal and organism. So every animal and organism evolve or likes to live in a particular habitat. So jab hum humans जब हम ह्यूमंस ने अशरफुल मखलूकात ह्यूमंस ने एनिमल को प्लैनेट अर्थ को मास्टर कर लिया, जब हमने इसको कॉन्कर कर लिया, हम अनइंटेंशनली बल्कि आई थिंक इंटेंशनली वी स्टार्टेड मेकिंग चेंजेस इन द हैबिटेट ऑफ मेनी मेनी एनिमल्स एंड वी डोंट केयर। अब जब हम दरख्त काटते हैं, व्हेन वी कट अ ट्री, वी डोंट नो हाउ इट इज अ हैबिटेट ऑफ हाउ सो मेनी डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिजम्स। यहाँ पर चिड़िया रह रही हैं, एनिमल्स प्लांट्स रह रहे हैं, बर्ड्स रह रहे हैं, इसके अंदर छोटे मोटे कीड़े मकोड़े रह रहे हैं। नोबडी नोज कि जब एक दरख्त कट के गिरता है दैट हाउ मेनी ऑर्गेनिजम्स लॉस्ट देयर हैबिटेट एट दैट टाइम। सो वी आर एक्चुअली कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग द हैबिटेट ऑफ डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड दैट इज अ रियल थ्रेट फॉर द वेरी मच सर्वाइवल ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म। जितनी भी स्पीशीज एक्सटिंक्ट हो गई हैं, इट इज नॉट कि हमने उनको खा लिया है, इट इज नॉट कि हमने उनको कत्ल कर दिया है। द स्पीशीज एक्सटिंक्ट हो गई हैं बिकॉज दे लॉस्ट देयर हैबिटेट, उनका नेचुरल हैबिटेट नहीं रहा। ओके, एंड ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे लाइक टू लिव इन अ हैबिटेट एंड लाइक टू लिव इन अ इन ग्रुप्स एज वेल। सो वंडरफुल ट्वीट ऑफ दैट बर्ड एज वेल। ओके, द नेक्स्ट थिंग ऑफ कोर्स इज द फूड। Why the food is required? Because the organisms needs to grow, they needs to survive. In order to keep or to sustain the metabolic chemical reaction going on within our body, we need to give them, we need to provide consistent supply of energy, we need to provide consistent supply of food. That consistent supply of energy is only possible if we give them the molecules which can generate energy. Food is required for two purposes. Number one, our body and our structure is made up of different molecules. We need those molecules to build our structures. अगर हमारे muscles टूट जाएंगे, अगर हम gym करते हैं, exercise करते हैं, अगर muscles टूट जाते हैं या injury हो जाती है, we need to rebuild our structures. So food is required because it contains the molecules which can build our structures, which can grow our structures. And the most important thing the food is doing, food is providing us the molecule which can be metabolized to produce energy. It contains essential materials for life. That is very, very important factor. On the basis of the food, we can divide organisms into three big groups. Actually, two big groups, but three big groups. Remember, three of them. Number one, the organisms which can create their own food. वो वाले ऑर्गेनिज्म जो अपनी खुराक खुद बना लेते हैं, विच कैन क्रिएट देयर ओन फूड बाय देमसेल्व्स, लाइक प्लांट्स, दे कैन प्रिपेयर देयर ओन फूड यूजिंग द सनलाइट एंड द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस एंड वाटर। कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस फ्रॉम द एयर, वाटर फ्रॉम द सोइल, पुट देम टुगेदर इन द ग्रीन पार्ट्स ऑफ देयर बॉडीज इन द लीव्स, विद द हेल्प ऑफ सनलाइट दे कैन प्रोड्यूस कार्बोहाइड्रेट, दे कैन प्रोड्यूस फूड। सच ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर कॉल्ड एज ऑटोट्रॉफिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स, यानी कहते हैं autotrophs, yeah, autotrophic organisms, and in another term we use for them are the producers. They are the producers for all the ecosystem. The second type of organisms who cannot prepare their own food and they are dependent for their food on the other organisms, they are called as heterotrophic organism. Yeah, in a heterotroph we kehte hain. Ye do tarah ke hote hain. Number one, either they are taking their food from the other plants and animals, they are called as consumers, like we are consumers, goats, cows, consumers, because they are taking their food from other organisms, from other plants. We are taking our food from other plants and animals, we are consumers. And if an organism is taking its food from the dead organism, that is called as a decomposer. Most of the bacteria and fungus and microorganisms, they are decomposers. And decomposers are doing some brilliant job for all of us. We don't know. How many of us decomposers kitna bada kaam karte hain? Ye dead bodies ko khatam kar dete hain. Living system jab khatam hota hai, the decomposers consumes the complex molecules present in the living system and convert them into simpler one, so that it can be used again to create life one more time. And the cycle goes on. So producers, consumers, and then the decomposers. You should know what is the difference between autotrophs and heterotrophs. Maybe in one of the interview I will be asking the difference between the heterotroph and the autotroph to you. Okay, next. different organism require different types of food, and that is where you should focus. Actually, this is a very critical part and the most important part, technical part of this chapter, that what are the molecules which are actually making the life, the molecules of life. The life is made up of different types of molecules. Some are present in more quantity as compared to the other. You know, number one, water, 70% water, main. The second, carbohydrate. The third is the lipids. The fourth is the protein. And the last, most beautiful one is the nucleic acid. And unfortunately, I should tell you, I don't know, my PhD is on that thing, the last thing. Okay, so these are the different molecules of life which are responsible for the beautiful phenomena which we call as life. If you ask me that whether the life is possible without one of them, the answer is no. If you ask me that whether any organism in the world we ever discovered which can exist without one of them, the answer is no. These five are the most fundamental components of life. Chahe wo bacteria hai, chahe wo plants hai, chahe wo animals hai, chahe wo birds hai, whatever the life form that is, it contains these fundamental components, although also they present in different proportions, but they are the fundamental components. And the most important elements present in life, you can guess, the atoms, the molecules present in life, they are carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, and phosphorus. Very important. All of them contribute to make important molecules. Carbohydrates. I will explain them one by one, okay? Lipids. And then look at the difficult one, adenosine triphosphate, ATP. Please repeat that word in your heart for two or three times. Adenosine triphosphate, ATP, adenosine triphosphate, ATP, and then the nucleic acid. Why I want you to emphasize on ATP, because whenever the energy is produced within a living system, you know, the energy will be produced by metabolizing food to produce energy to execute the function of life. Like maine baat karni hai, my muscles needs to move. The muscles of my body are required to move. Iske liye energy chahiye. That energy will come by metabolizing carbohydrates. But when the carbohydrates are metabolized, they burn down actually. But burn down in a very controlled way. When they burn down, they produce heat. And that heat is utilized to produce ATP. ATP is like a currency of energy in every living system. यूनिवर्सली बड़ी ये एवोल्यूशन वाले जो है ना वो इसको एज एन आर्गुमेंट इस्तेमाल करते हैं कि दुनिया की कोई भी लाइफ फॉर्म है एवरी लाइफ फॉर्म प्रेजेंट आउट देयर दे यूज द सेम करेंसी ऑफ एनर्जी वो जो मर्जी मेटाबॉलिज्म का प्रोसेस इस्तेमाल करें दे प्रोड्यूस द सेम टाइप ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल विच इज कॉल्ड एज एडिनोसिन ट्राइफॉस्फेट दिस इज द एनर्जी मॉलिक्यूल सो वेन एवर द एनर्जी इज रिक्वायर्ड द फूड इज मेटाबोलाइज टू प्रोड्यूस एटीपी एंड देन द एटीपी इज स्टोर्ड विद इन द बॉडी And then that ATP is utilized wherever it is required. और आपको एक मजे की बात बताता हूँ. You might wonder, जो हम food खाते हैं, carbohydrate produce करते हैं. 80% of that carbohydrate and energy and ATP is consumed by what? Guess. हम कितना कुछ खाते हैं, उससे कितना कुछ energy बनती होगी. उसकी 80% energy, यानी के जो ATP produce होता है, that is produced by one organ. Guess the name of the organ. आ जाओ मैदान में
सर लिवर
शाबाश और मैं एंड में बताऊंगा ठीक किसका है यू कैन स्पीक और यू कैन टाइप स्पीक इज जी जी वाजिद
हार्ट
हार्ट शाबाश और सारे तुक्के ना मारे एक बार ओके नेक्स्ट सारे ऑर्गन बोल दे कोई ना कोई तो होगा ब्रेन ओके 80% of whatever the energy you are producing in your body and in my body is consumed by the brain. Ek chota sa adha kilo ka organ is consuming everything which we are producing. So yahan se hame lagta hai kabhi kabhi aapko hairat hogi main aapko mazi ajeeb si baat batane laga hu ghabrana na we are slave of that half a kilo organ. Hum jo bhi karte hain whatever we are doing for the sake of the very much survival of that thing which we called as brain. वो कहता है सबसे ज्यादा पहले मेरी एनर्जी, सबसे ज्यादा मैं खाऊंगा, जो बचेगा फिर हार्ट और फिर बाकी सारे। द हार्ट इज वर्किंग फॉर ब्रेन, द ब्लड इज वर्किंग फॉर ब्रेन, एवरी अदर ऑर्गन इज वर्किंग फॉर द वेरी मच सर्वाइवल ऑफ द ब्रेन। ब्रेन इज द मास्टर, एक्चुअली ब्रेन इज व्हाट यू कैन कंसिडर एज, यू नो, वो जो आप फिलोसॉफिकल कंसिडर एज सोल और वट एवर, इट्स लाइक मास्टर ऑफ एवरीथिंग। Another important compound which you might remember or aapne suna hoga, that is the proteins. And proteins are made up of little small components, monomers. They are called as amino acids. Aapne kabhi term suna polymer? Polymer kehte hain big molecule ko. Poly ka matlab hota hai many, polymer, many units. Every polymer is made up of small units. And those small units are called as monomer. So monomers merge together to make polymer. And polymer are very big molecules. So amino acids are the monomers. When they merge together, they make the big molecule called proteins. There are 20 different kinds of amino acids present in living system. Aur ye bhi ek ajeeb baat hai ki every living system have the same 20 types of amino acids. These 20 amino acids connect themselves in different numbers and different sequence to make different types of proteins. Oh my God! It's like alphabets. Hijje hote hain na English ke. It's like alphabets A B C D E F G H. The alphabets can put them. You can put these alphabets together in different numbers and different sequence to make words. And you put those words together in different numbers and different sequence to make the sentences, and then sentences to paragraphs, and then paragraphs to the stories. And those stories are proteins. And actually, it was written with the help of 20 basic alphabets, which are called as amino acids. If the sequence of the amino acid is changed, the protein and its function will be changed. Like, maybe muscles are bicep, tricep. I am not a macho man, but I do have a muscles. It's a bicep, there's a tricep. These muscles are made up of proteins. The goat and the cow, they do have the muscles, and their muscles is made up of proteins as well. Wo log kehte na hum gosht khayenge, chicken khayenge to hamara gosht ban jayega. Na, people think like this. Waise buri baat nahi hai, lekin 100% wo bhi protein hai. The chicken meat is a protein, but the chicken meat is different from my muscle meat, because the sequence of amino acids in the chicken meat is different and the sequence of amino acids in my muscles are different. That is why it's a different protein and the chicken meat is a different protein. Jab hum chicken khate hain, meat khate hain, hum ek protein khate hain, our body disassemble the amino acids. Hamara body amino acids ko disassemble kar deta hai. They separate the amino acids. सबको अलग अलग कर देता दोबारा से, एंड देन दे पुट देम टुगेदर अगेन टू क्रिएट आवर ओन प्रोटीन्स। तो जब मीट खाते हैं तो उस मीट से क्या होता है, दे सेपरेट द अमीनो एसिड्स एंड देन वी रीजॉइन देम टू क्रिएट द प्रोटीन्स ऑफ आवर ओन चॉइस। एंड याद रखें, और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट, प्रोटीन्स आर डूइंग स्ट्रक्चरल वर्क, दे आर पार्ट ऑफ आवर स्ट्रक्चर, दे आर डूइंग मेंटेनेंस वर्क, they are producing energy, they are support structures like skin, horns, nails, bones, they are transporting oxygen from one place to another. Blood ke andar the red color of the blood is because of the presence of a protein called hemoglobin, and hemoglobin is responsible to capture the oxygen from the lungs and then carry that oxygen to the rest of the body. Whenever a bad guy enters into our body, like germs, virus, pathogen enters into our body tries to fight with that microorganism. Hamari body us germ se ladti hai. They started producing weapons to kill that invading aliens. And those weapons are called as antibodies. They are also proteins. If we want to move from one place to another, we need to move our body. We need to move our skeleton. And that is because of the muscles, and muscles are proteins. Many important hormones are proteins, like insulin. मेटाबॉलिज्म कंट्रोल करता है कार्बोहाइड्रेट का, शुगर लेवल कंट्रोल करता है बॉडी में. जिन लोगों में इंसुलिन कॉमन अच्छे से पैदा नहीं होता, दे डेवलप डायबिटीज. एंड फाइनली द लास्ट बट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंजाइम्स, इसको याद रखिएगा, ये बहुत जरूरी बात है. आई टोल्ड यू लाइफ इज अबाउट द मेटाबॉलिक केमिकल रिएक्शंस गोइंग ऑन इन विद इन आवर बॉडी. ऑल दोज मेटाबॉलिक केमिकल रिएक्शंस, each step of those metabolic chemical reactions require a support, require a catalyst, and that catalyst is called as enzyme, and by structure it is protein. After listening all that thing, you might feel there is no life, there is no concept of life without protein, because no metabolism can be executed without enzymes, and enzymes are all proteins, hormones proteins, movement proteins, fighting against a disease, antibodies proteins, transport of material proteins, energy productions protein, structure proteins, which is that much critical for the very much survival of life. Okay, I am holding my lecture at the protein here because I want you people to brainstorm your questions related to these things to me in the remaining part of our session. And we have many beautiful things related to the protein. Spider silk jo hoti hai wo bhi protein hoti hai. एक टॉक बता रहा था कि ह्यूमंस जो है ना वो सुपीरियर क्यों होते हैं, व्हाई ह्यूमंस आर सुपीरियर रेस देन द अदर ऑर्गेनिज्म. हालांकि दूसरे ऑर्गेनिज्म बहुत अच्छा अच्छा काम कर सकते हैं हमारे. मैंने कहा कि हम नहीं, मुझे नहीं पता कि हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट दैट वेब. हम नहीं बना सकते, स्पाइडर कैन क्रिएट दैट वेब, एंड स्टिल आई एम सुपीरियर देन स्पाइडर. एंड द मसल्स, हॉर्न्स आर ऑल ब्यूटीफुल थिंग्स, दे आर प्रोटीन्स. ओके, एंड नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द कार्बोहाइड्रेट इन द सेकंड सेशन. द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज इंपॉर्टेंट एज वेल. From proteins onward, it is very important information, and you need to take all that information with you. Right click. Okay. So, in our last class, we started learning about the different important molecules of life. And if you can recall that we were trying to study that there are fundamental molecules of life like water, carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acid. And we started right away with the thing called as proteins. Proteins, they are made up of small monomers, small building blocks called amino acids. I told you, like alphabets, they assemble together in different sequence. They assemble together in different numbers, in different sequence, in different numbers to produce different types of proteins. There are thousands of types of proteins out there in different animals. Even humans contains like more than 1,000 types of protein present in our own body. Muscles are made up of different proteins. Hairs are made up of different proteins. Hemoglobin is made up of different proteins. Skin is made up of different proteins. Nails are made up of different proteins. So we have like, it's like real functional molecules present in a living system. ये वो molecules हैं जो काम करते हैं, जो jobs करते हैं, जो कुछ चीज execute करते हैं. That's why they are very important. They create support structures. They transport material. I gave you example. Hemoglobin, transferrin. These are molecules which can capture oxygen, carbon dioxide gas from one place and take it to the other place. Antibodies, which fight against the diseases. Proteins. They help in movement like muscles. Hormones. They help in metabolism and other things. Growth factors. And then, of course, the enzymes. Enzyme is like everything. Every living organism is a mixture of lots of different types of chemical reactions, and those chemical reactions are catalyzed by enzymes. What that mean, catalyzed by enzyme? I mean that if the enzyme is not there, the chemical reaction will proceed with a very very minimum speed, and that speed is not enough to sustain life. With the help of enzyme, the same chemical reaction can be proceeded in a very fast speed, good enough to sustain the functions of life. Just to add you a little complexity, when we see things, badi ajeeb baat, when we see things, the light enters into our eyes, it goes to the retina. Aankhon ke piche ek parda hai, deewar hai aankhon ke piche wali, it made up of a specialized cells called rods and cones. When light strike with the rods and cone cells, it trigger a chemical reaction. Different types of lights enter into our body, they trigger different types of chemical reactions. all different types of chemical reactions create different types of nerve impulses, and our brain interpret all those nerve impulses to create the image for us. So जब हम देखते हैं हम कितना ग्रांटेड लेते हैं उसको, इधर देखें उधर देखें ऊपर देखें. अगर आपके विजन में दो कलर्स हैं ओनली, आई कैन टेल यू देयर शेड्स ऑफ ग्रेड्स ऑफ रेंज ऑफ कलर्स आउट देयर. एक ही इमेज में हम बहुत सारे रेड भी देख रहे हैं, व्हाइट भी देख रहे हैं, ब्राउन भी देख रहे हैं. देयर आर दैट मेनी केमिकल रिएक्शंस गोइंग ऑन विद इन योर आईज. इतने सारे केमिकल रिएक्शन होते हैं आपकी आंखों में एट दैट टाइम. And each of that chemical reaction produces different signal, and your brain interpret all those signals to create that image. Manzar badalte, the brain have to work this, you know, again and again and again and again and again. Acha, us series of chemical reactions ko catalyze karne ke liye hume kya chahiye? Enzymes. If you don't have enough supply of enzymes, that means you will not be able to see the things properly. Particularly, there are some other associated important elements are also required to assist your vision. Unme se ek bada mashhoor hai jiska naam hai vitamin A. Kehte na vitamin A khane wale ki aankhein bahut achhi rehti hain. Because vitamin A is part of that chemical reactions which ended up in creating that signal. Aur jin logon ki body mein vitamin A kam hoga, they find it difficult. The people with a lesser amount of vitamin A naturally in their body, they're not eating well, they're not getting vitamin A from their food well. Those people will find it difficult to process those signals. And they lost their signals and lost their, you know, vision and their capacity. So proteins are like everything. It's like functional molecule. Abhi log debate karte hain. People are like debating on this argument that what was the actual start of life? It was actually the appearance of DNA. And jab pehli martaba nucleic acid duniya mein kainat mein samne aaya, that was the time when we should consider life is starting. Or जब पहला फंक्शनल मॉलिक्यूल यानी कि पहला प्रोटीन सामने आया, उस दिन को हमें समझना चाहिए कि दैट वाज द टाइम व्हेन एक्चुअली लाइफ स्टार्टेड. सो इट्स अ वेरी वंडरफुल डिबेट गोइंग ऑन. लोग इसको अपना आर्ग्यू करते रहते हैं. देयर आर ब्यूटीफुल थिंग्स एसोसिएटेड विद द प्रोटीन्स. द नेक्स्ट इज द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. यू माइट रिमेंबर द टर्म. आप अगर न्यूट्रिशन वगैरह में इंटरेस्टेड है, यू नो कार्ब्स एंड प्रोटीन्स, यू ऑलरेडी नो दीज टर्मिनोलॉजीज. कार्बोहाइड्रेट इज अ मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल. इट्स अनदर पॉलीमर. ये भी एक पॉलीमर है लाइक प्रोटीन्स. इज अ प्रोटीन्स आर पॉलीमर. Made up of what? Made up of amino acids. Carbohydrates, they are polymer. Yes, they are made up of small units called sugars. They are made up of small components called glucose. Glucose is one of the member. There are other members as well, but just to make things easier, the small repeating unit glucose merged together in different numbers to create carbohydrates. The term carbohydrate actually means hydrated carbon. I will explain that thing in detail in a separate chapter. Hydrated carbon means the molecule which contains a carbon attached with a water molecule. It is called as hydrated carbon. And the primary purpose, the primary agenda of carbohydrate in living system is to produce energy. सबसे बड़ा काम, the job of carbohydrate is to produce energy. They are energy producing molecules. They also participate in creating cellular structures. ye structural living matter ko banane mein bhi istemal, part of the living matter cellular structures ka hissa hai, structurally bhi istemal hote hain, but the primary purpose of carbohydrate is to produce energy. Some carbohydrates are simple. Some carbohydrates are bigger and complex. Some carbohydrates are only made up of glucose, but some carbohydrates are complex and they have proteins or even lipids associated with them. ये term याद रहे तो क्या बात है. Number one, अगर किसी carbohydrate के साथ if a protein is associated with a carbohydrate, it is called as glycoprotein. It is called as glycoprotein. Glycoprotein का मतलब carbohydrate plus lipids. If sorry, let me repeat the line. Okay, don't lose at this time. If a protein is associated with carbohydrate, it is called as glycoprotein. सही बोला था मैंने. इफ अ लिपिड इज एसोसिएटेड विद कार्बोहाइड्रेट इट इज कॉल्ड एज ग्लाइकोलिपिड. इफ अ लिपिड इज एसोसिएटेड विद कार्बोहाइड्रेट इट इज कॉल्ड एज ग्लाइकोलिपिड. ये जो लोग इसमें इंटरेस्टेड हैं, ये जो पैंडेमिक में या वायरस में और आजकल बहुत सीरियसली फॉलो करते रहे हैं ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, वायरस को स्टडी करने की कोशिश करते रहे हैं, उसके बारे में आर्टिकल वगैरह पढ़ते रहे, उन्होंने सुना होगा द कोविड 19 जो बीमारी है उसको जो वायरस उसको उसकी वजह है, द वायरस विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कोविड 19 दैट इज SARS-CoV-2, द वायरस कोड प्रोटीन कैस्पिड प्रोटीन कोड प्रोटीन इज अ ग्लाइकोलिपिड प्रोटीन. वो साइंसदान जब बोलते हैं ना ग्लाइकोलिपिड है उसके सरफेस के ऊपर, दैट ग्लाइकोलिपिड मींस इट इज मेड अप ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट एज वेल एज द लिपिड्स, बट द प्राइमरी पर्पस इज टू प्रोड्यूस एनर्जी. And the complex carbohydrates, the bigger carbohydrates, their job is to store energy. When we eat food, it is made up of proteins, carbohydrates, fats, and all these things. Our digestive system digests the food, convert them, these big molecules, into simpler ones within our digestive system. And our body assimilate, consume those molecules. Misal ke taur par, for example, the protein will be converted into amino acid, the carbohydrate will be converted into glucose, the fats are converted into fatty acids and simpler molecules. So big molecules converted into simpler ones, and then we reuse them. If we eat carbohydrate, if our food is made up of carbohydrate, in that case we eventually receive glucose at the end of the digestion. Khana khane ke baad, after the digestion, we receive glucose because the carbohydrate is converted into the glucose. That glucose is just then assimilated by our blood, our body. Zara, microphone on, stop kar lijiye please. That carbohydrate is then entered into the bloodstream, from where we use that carbohydrate, from where we use that carbohydrate to produce energy. But what if we do not require energy at that time? What if we do not require energy at that time? क्या हो अगर हमें उस वक्त एनर्जी की जरूरत नहीं है? देन वी ज्वाइन एंड असेंबल दोस ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड स्टोर इट विद इन आवर मसल्स एंड विद इन आवर लिवर प्राइमरली. अगर हमें उस वक्त ग्लूकोज की जरूरत नहीं है तो हम क्या करेंगे? वी विल असेंबल एंड कन्वर्ट दोस ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल्स इंटू बिग कार्बोहाइड्रेट मॉलिक्यूल्स. We consume the free glucose. For example, this is the glucose units. We assemble those glucose units and make big carbohydrate molecules and then store within our liver and muscles so that we can use it later on. जब हमें चाहिए हम इसको इस्तेमाल कर लें. Please keep this thing. It's very important right now. अगर हमारी body, if our body fails to take care of that free glucose. मैंने कार्बोहाइड्रेट खाया, मैंने खाना खाया एंड आई एम नॉट कंज्यूमिंग द ग्लूकोज. ग्लूकोज कब कंज्यूम होगा? व्हेन वी प्रोड्यूस, व्हेन वी नीड एनर्जी. इफ आई एम नॉट वर्किंग वेल, इफ आई एम नॉट फिजिकली वर्किंग वेरी वेल, इफ आई एम नॉट एक्सरसाइजिंग, इफ आई एम नॉट लिविंग एन एक्टिव लाइफ, आई एम टेकिंग कार्बोहाइड्रेट, दैट कार्बोहाइड्रेट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज, द ग्लूकोज मस्ट बी यूज्ड. बट इफ आई एम नॉट यूजिंग इट, माय बॉडी विल यूटिलाइज दोस फ्री ग्लूकोज एंड कन्वर्ट देम इनटू big molecules, convert them into carbohydrate and store within our liver and our muscles with the help of a hormone called insulin. ye kaam wo ek hormone ki madad se karti hai jise kehte hain insulin. if a person failed to produce enough insulin, if a person is failed to produce enough insulin, what will happen? That person will not be able to convert its free glucose. That person will not be able to convert its free glucose will not be able to preserve its free glucose, and its bloodstream contains lots of glucose. That person is called as diabetic. And this disease is called as diabetes, the abnormal metabolism of glucose. The presence of free glucose in the blood means a disease. It will cause trouble. Trouble for the kidneys and for the other organs. So that's why insulin convert them into carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are very important. We require, we need for every other purpose to produce energy. But if we are not consuming it, that carbohydrate will be stored within our liver and muscles. And then can be used later on. Okay.